G'day all, Mr. Paladin here, and today I'm playing some Batman Arkham Knight, because I want to talk about being somebody's hero. And a lot of people, including people who are very young, do not believe that they are somebody's hero. But I'm here to tell you that concept is incorrect. There is always somebody watching you, judging you, determining your value to them or your value to the world based solely on what they're seeing you do. Every time I've talked to young people, they think they have little or no impact because you see big world events, right? You see the big world events going on right now, you see politics, you see stuff in the news, and the fact that you're a polite, quiet lad or lass seems insignificant. It seems like it makes no difference whatsoever. There was a movie several years ago called Pay It Forward, where it tried to talk about that very concept. A teacher challenged the students to come up with a way to change the world. And one student thought about it and came back and said, "Hey, you know, I don't have to change the entire world, but if I can make an impact in the lives of just two people and then have those people make an impact to two other people, you can pay it forward and change the world over time." And that is a very nice concept until you introduce the fact that there are some true villains in the world, and no matter the fact if somebody pays it forward to two people, if you pay it forward and those people are just villains, they're just takers, and they're not people to pass it on, then that system kind of dies. But it doesn't break up the core concept that you should make an impact, just a small impact, to those people around you, to those that you have some influence on, and you don't realize you have the influence. You have influence over your classmates, you have influence over your teachers, you have influence with your parents. Now, that's not to say that those role models you look up to don't also have reciprocating value back to you, but understand that you do have an impact. Everything you do, everything you say, every action you take is judged by someone, and it's most obvious in the fact of siblings. If you have a really young sibling, they look up to you and adore you flawlessly, especially when they're itty bitty. So I want you to get it out of your mind, the whole concept that in order to be a hero, you have to have some sort of superpower, or you have to have vast wealth, or you have to have a cape, or you have to have a batarang, or you have to have heat ray vision or something like that. That's not going to happen, okay? That is the fanciful stuff of comic books, and until we get gene manipulation a la, you know, X-Men or something like that, we're not going to be having that evolution of humankind. But you can have heroes who are saving the world. How many times do you see in the news there's some case where someone's done something truly vile, or there's some big world event like going on now, and some everyday person has made an action and been called a hero? And when they interview these people, they look straight in the camera and they will tell you, "Hey, I'm not a hero. I'm just doing the thing that anyone else in my situation would have done." Now, while that is adorable to think about, it's not always the case. People don't always do that. A lot of people would run in the situation. We'd like to think that everyone would step up when the time comes, but it doesn't happen. But I want to encourage you to be the type of person who will step forward in that time of need. It doesn't have to be anything drastic. There just has to be action. Because how many times has somebody given you lip service? They will talk a big game, but when the time comes, they don't actually do anything. You know the old saying, actions speak louder than words. Well, it's true. A lot of people will tell you they're a good person. They will tell you they're charitable, they'll tell you they're honorable. But until the moment comes when they actually have to do something, in the moment, you won't know for sure. Politics is a fantastic example of this. How many politicians have said one thing, then done another? Now, is this the fact that the politician just doesn't remember what they've promised in the past? You know, it's a memory thing? Or do you think they're just saying what you want to hear them say just so they can get away with whatever it is they're getting away with? You know, almost like a cheesy villain. I went looking up right now what they're wanting young people to do to be a hero these days. And the biggest influence I could find was that they're wanting an anti-bullying initiative. They're wanting young folk to stand up when they see somebody being bullied and protect them. And that's perfectly easy to say, but to do is another situation entirely. You know, we'd all like to say, hey, no, we're against bullying, right? There is absolutely no way that we'll stand up for somebody who's weak getting picked on by somebody who's strong. And I find that's not the case. I find more and more, in fact, that there is video evidence of people bullying other people, posting it up on social media, and that stuff getting so many likes and so many views for the absolute wrong reasons. You know, people get kind of detached from the situation, so the situation doesn't seem so bad to them. In fact, they see the humor in it when there shouldn't be any humor at all. So there's a few things I'm going to encourage you to do that don't need any social status at all. It doesn't need any money to do. But if you do these things, people will observe it and you will be a hero to somebody. It is a real simple concept to change the world, because somebody will see you doing this and that will change their attitude, and the next person's attitude will change, just like the pay it forward kind of scenario. Now, I do want to say that the first judge of somebody's character is who they surround themselves with. Now, unlike our Cape Crusader here, we're going to have a choice not to surround ourselves with villains. And while he is standing apart from the villains, you will find that in real life, people will surround themselves with like-minded individuals. It's how such simple concepts as gangs evolve. I mean, if somebody hangs out in a community that's known to grief, who's known to cheat, the idea that you could probably judge that they are a cheater or a griefer is pretty darn high. But nowadays, I want to see that we're going beyond just who you're surrounding yourself with physically. I'm talking about who you surround yourself with socially. Who do you follow on social media? Who are you subscribed to on YouTube? What TV series do you watch and stuff like that? Is it wholesome? Is it encouraging? Is it uplifting? So many times on my own social media and my own YouTube channel and such as that, I've decided to unsubscribe from folks, I've decided to remove folks, I've decided to block folks based on their actions, based on who they associate themselves with, because there's nothing wholesome coming out of those groups. And it actually discourages me sometimes, because, like, there's some people that I wanted to look up to. I wanted them to be there, but, for example, there were some voice actors for different games. And I really appreciate their characters in the games, and I really appreciate the work that they put into the games, and, you know, there's no taking that back. I love what they've done with the characters. But as I followed them on social media, I found that their political views were different, or their social views were different. And while differences are not the real problem, I mean, we should be able to discuss alternate views with each other. They took such a strong stance, or they were forwarding information on their social media that was proven untrue, and I tried to reach out to them and say, hey, you know, this stuff has already been thwarted, here's the hard evidence and the statistics against it. And they've just, like, doubled down on it, or they keep going to these untrustworthy sources and stuff like that. So I've had to remove myself from it, because on my own social media, people can see who I follow, people can see who I like, and such as that. So it could reflect poorly upon me when they see this poor activity happening across social media. You don't have to have as far a reach as I have. It doesn't matter if you've got one person following you, two people following you, only your family members following you. Doesn't matter. I don't care if you've got 100,000 bazillion people following you and liking everything you throw up on social media. You have reach. You're putting yourself out there. What you're typing up is searchable. It's like printing it on a newspaper and publishing it to the people you care about. So you've got to be wary as to who's watching it. Because you do influence them. If you just put out pessimistic stuff, pessimism is going to surround you. Likewise, if you publish optimistic material, optimism will surround you. Things will be uplifting. You'll get encouragement from your fellow peers and family members. So that's what I want to do. I don't want you to have a cape. I don't want you to have fighting skills. I don't want you to have a huge amount of money. I'm not here to tell you you should try and step in the way of a bully to stop a fight, even though I'd love you to. People still look out for number one. They don't want to have physical harm while they try and help someone else. And there really are truly evil and vile people in this world who seek to do harm, who seek death upon other people. And we need to stand up to that. We need to find a way to stop it. If you can't stop it yourself, at least find a way to get help to others who are able and equipped to stop it. I don't need you to throw money at the problem. I don't need you to have a big social reach. I just want you to influence the people who are around you, because you do influence the people around you. That is the main point I want to get across. You influence your siblings. You make an impression on your parents, your work colleagues, your school colleagues, the people you hang out with. Everything you say and do is judged, is categorized, is observed for a pattern. And I just want you to be the best person that you possibly can be, and grow from there. Be the type of person now that in the future you look back on and you're thinking, man, I made such a difference in the lives of, and you could list off a couple of people. So for example, in my own youth, I remember the next door neighbor kid. He was an only child, and he was younger than me and my brother. But we would always interact with him. He was younger than us. I mean, people our age at the time, we were teenagers. You wouldn't have hung out with a kid younger than your teens. You just wouldn't. But we would often take time out of our day to hang out, to play the younger kid games that he would want to play. And the way we acted around him, I have seen later in his life as I went to visit my parents that we did make a huge impact. His mother even came up to us and said she was so glad that we were there for him, because like his dad wasn't in the picture. But me and my brother, we were almost like pseudo parents to this kid. And I was so glad to have her say that. I was so happy that we were able to make such an impact. We didn't have huge influence. We didn't have money. We were just being good people to other people. I hope you have that experience in your life as well. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. If you enjoyed this video, go ahead and check out other videos in this series where I play various video games and just give tips and life lessons to gamers.